Thank you. Oh, Thank you. Come on. Come on. Bodyguard! Come on, come on. Thank you. The first year we set up a junior D, and I think we had no conceived walk hours in junior D this year compared to last year where they're all at junior.
Stop, Lennon!
And I think it worked out well. It's great to see young and old players as well. I hope you all enjoy it. Look forward to meeting the junior C next year. I'd like to thank the Curling Club for having the facility in fantastic condition. Everything laid on for us, and thanks so much, Curtis. To
our sponsor, O'Connell Construction, thanks very much. To our referee, Martin Collins, and his two linesmen, and his umpires for refereeing the game. Did a fine job. And above all, let's once you go home, good and healthy, and enjoy your game of football. That's all we care. It's great to see you, guys.
Bye-bye.
It's my man of the match, and it goes to number 15, Keith Murphy. A brand new cup, lads, and I hope it comes back as shiny as this.
First
time I think Britain's won a hurling title, and it's great to see small clubs competing and going on. My Connell have great success in the hurling football, and a fantastic club, but it's great to see small club win the county title. So I know Connell Tomas to accept it.
On behalf of St. Brendan's Club, I'd like to thank the County Board for setting up all this competitions and everything for us. It'll be a thankless job at times, but fair play to them. They run a tight ship. It takes a lot of organising. To the referees and the umpires and that's another thankless job, but fair play to them. Refed excellently, so it was, throughout. There was plenty of hard hitting and belting and that off the ball, which I'd expect nothing less in the final. To Moy Cullen, fair play to you on a fine sporting occasion. It was fine, it was football the way football should have been played. There was no nasty stuff, no mass defences or anything like that. It was go for broke all the time, and that's the way it should be. To our own club, this is only our third ever senior county title or county cup county cup that's in the club. So, I know my Cullen are well used to winning county finals and that, but I'm afraid we aren't. So, to the lads that I played with all year, fair play to you. At different occasions, I said this at the North Board final, on different occasions we had 15 and 12 and 11, I think, on one or two occasions. And we had 13 players named in the end, which is massive, so it is for our club. to management and our... His amigos, to Ronan Collins. He kept himself number 9 early on in the year. He knew with the view that he was going to get to a county title. So he was manager. He put this gig together, and in fairness to him, he has put in a lot of hours and a lot of work in it. So he has getting lads together, and it can't be easy at times. To his two amigos, to his sidekicks, sports psychologist Shane Lohan, as I told you before, and Michael Hannon, the brains of the operation. One more person as well here, he was actually captain at the beginning of the year, our honorary corpsman, Padraig Callaghan. Unfortunately, due to injury in the very first game, Podge was ruled out for the rest of the career, but he's about 36 now, which means that he'll have another 10 or 12 years playing the way. So, without further ado, thanks to everyone, and enjoy the night.
Oh. Okay. Have it. All good. Thank you.
Kerry.
Hey, you want to hear that? Joe! residents of Ballygar on the for the celebration dinner after the Junior D Championship game. Great win today for the lads. 111-170 against Mike Cullen. Took touch and go for most of the game, but in the end they squeezed out a valuable win. So we're just going to go around now for a few memories. It was only last night, Matt Noon put up a famous video of 2002. And God rest him, there's a lot of people not there then, not here now, that were there then. And I'm sure if this video is looked at in 20 years' time, there'll be some of us not there then.
We're here now.
So we'll start with, I think we'll start with the goalie, Seamus Kelly, I think. We're not going to interview everyone, but we just talk with Seamus.
For fuck's sake, come back in your goal.
No need to sit down, no need to sit down, Laura, you're all good. Good game today.
Not too bad.
A big improvement on the semi-final. I think your kick-outs were 90% effective today.
Weren't great the last day.
Not great. We'll say no more about that now. You did well anyway. You got good cover from the lads in front of you though.
I did, yeah, but probably should have been better with the goal.
Yeah, what happened there? What happened there? I suppose you could blame the banks.
Yeah, I don't want to make it interesting a bit.
Okay, but in general,
it's not enough performance, probably should have won by more. Kickouts were good, but the lads made it handy enough picking them out.
Opposition tough enough? Hard to play against.
Yeah, they weren't too bad, I suppose. They were physical.
Big hand in here and
Jerry McGinnis got a nice shoulder.
Well, you expect that in GAA games. It's part of the job, you know.
I liked it, to be honest. It was a good hit.
They
were a tricky team to play in. They were just physical. They probably made hard work.
He came out of the good end, though. Thanks a million.
And we'll have a good drink tonight.
I'd just like to extend my congratulations to everybody involved, all the panel. I think we mentioned Ronan Collins here as the manager.
Player manager.
It's a difficult post. I think I had a season or two at it myself. Not one that you can escape criticism from. But someone has to do it, and I think you were low in numbers early on. I think there was something like 30-something on this list today. Yeah. And I suppose it vindicates the Junior D, where it might be frowned upon by somebody. And I said to somebody there at the game today, like, it's probably enjoyable as a lot of the inter-county games on the television this year. You know, everybody makes mistakes. And tomorrow, there'll be mistakes tomorrow as well. Moving on from there now... we'll have to mention the sports psychologist. He's gone. Shane Lohan, who are with you, Ronan, and Michael Hannon, of course. Mike?
Hi,
Mick. Come on here. I'm making up this as I go along, so.
So will I.
Don't feel offended.
No.
Just a few general thoughts on the game. Include maybe the campaign. I think somebody said that the lads played 7 games this year.
Yeah.
And it was a good campaign overall.
It was, and it was great fun. You see by the panel of 32 lads named today, and every one of them, from 1 to the 32, played a part. Padraig O'Callaghan got badly upended in the first game.
I know.
And ended up with an old trip to A&E.
He's still alive, though.
He's still alive.
Yeah, that's okay.
Although...
Tell them
what
he was talking about, Mike.
He was awful in love on the way to that.
Oh, dear. That's okay, too, right?
All he was worried about is the poor wife.
That's fine. Yeah.
And he wants to know the number of the fella that did the damage. That's all he wants to know about.
That's not good now. Revenge plotted there.
Yeah, but he never got to meet him again.
He might yet, though.
Till next year.
Well, next year is always next year. Yeah. Sure, he's only, 46, 47. So, 4 years after him.
Yeah. That's been.
Go on, but from there on, sure, look at, as I say, everyone played a part. Wins up in Milltown one day, barely had 15, 16 players. John Finneran had a disaster of a first half, couldn't take him off at half time. Second half,
why?
We'd no sub. However, okay. The second half he was like a man transformed. Yeah. Kicked 5 pints that you wouldn't see a bum crow pair. Yeah. He's probably up at the bar.
I think I saw that on the screen, the score of one. I was wondering if John Finneran won 3.
Yeah.
I thought it was a misprint. Now, with all due to John.
It made good sense that you thought it was a mistake, because we thought it was a mistake as well, but it happened. Yeah. But got us over the line. And performances like that got us into the semi-final, with a home semi-final. If we'd lost that semi-final against, or that group game against Milltown, we could have had an away semi-final against Kelly Connolly, who proved to be probably one of our toughest oppositions on the way through. So, as I say, everyone helped. Horrick Noon played games, Nathan Downey played games. You know, numerous other lads.
A lot of lads that didn't play today were there at the beginning of the campaign.
Exactly. And everyone contributed.
Three cheers to them lads as well. Here. That's grand. Thanks, Mike.
All right, no problem.
I was non-match.
Jerry Kay, chairman of the club. 30 seconds. Come on. Your general thoughts on the competition, the worthwhileness of the competition, the efficiency of running it off by the county board, etc., all that?
No, I thought it was a great competition. I thought the professionalism, I said it to Tom Shocks earlier, even not just today, but in the last few, in all the games, you know, in terms of the way the county board ran it, I thought it was a credit to them. It was really, you would have thought it was a senior championship game. Yeah. I'd just like to thank the lads. I'd like to thank Dolly for taking it over. Hi, Dolly. Hi, Dolly. Hi, Dolly. Hi, Dolly. Hi, Dolly. Hi, Dolly. When people take something over and you get a bit of commitment, what's possible? And I know Podge started in the first game, and fair play to Podge, came in behind them. I'd like to Jimmy there in the background, Jimmy Hannon, played fullback all year. And Jimmy, I know, tough, I was talking before the game. It's tough to sit out a county final, but fair play to you. You didn't try. You said, look, I'm injured. Let's give somebody else a chance. So fair play to you as well. The last thing I say to them was, look, lads, this is not the end. This should be the start to something. A lot of you guys are going to be involved in this intermediate team this year. Good few of you. And we're playing the first round championship in two weeks' time. So this should be the start. I said to Shocks, you couldn't script a better year. He got married. I know many cups you have to win, and your new house,
new wife, 2 cups in 2 months.
So well done, 2 shots.
I think that deserves a bowl of bus.
Wait, give him 2 more months, and you have 2 kids. One last thing, though. Next year, let's just be. There's no reason why we couldn't put it all together again next year and go for the next level up.
Because there's a few young lads.
Oh, yeah. I counted 32 lads there today when I was talking to Jimmy before the game for a second team. It's something to be proud of. So, well done, lads. Enjoy the evening. Let's go.
Thanks, William. After that, now I think I'll have to thank
our... One last thing. I want to recognise Matthew Noon as... And Dibley is our treasurer, but Matthew Noon is probably the best secretary that any club could have. So.
And not forgetting our cameraman Brian Coe. Himself and Matt Noon did a deadly combination. Pure IT. Pure IT. Quick whiskey to get back to you in a minute.
Yeah, correct.
Good talking to man of the match today, score of 111. I think he ended up with a score of 5 pints.
3 from Freezer.
3 from Freezer. You hit one outrageous one there from way out in the left corner with the left foot.
Was that the one?
Someone said it was heading for Tune, but tell me.
Well, you know, Tomas, I'm like my Uncle Jimmy. I'm a great footballer, I'm all talk. I know, privileged playing with these lads. Privileged to play with these lads all year. Yeah. This guy starts the year, doubles all on, and I don't think we would have won it without Tomás, Dolly, Mike Hannon, John Finner.
Everybody
played. 5 points on Milton by
John, yeah, you know, that. We're coming to him later now. But he has that point right.
I know, seriously though, great year, honestly. Yeah.
And it's great. Yeah.
Good to have a second team in the club. Like last year was the shit show, everyone knows that.
Remember!
Hurling men like Philly Garrity, you know. like to think they're hurling men anyway, Tomás.
Yeah, but tell them all about that.
Yeah,
thanks really, Pete.
I will hear the hurling today.
Neither will I. We get Tomás Loughlin. Sean Loughlin came on there. Probably have 2 minutes, Sean. One of the sub that came on, I think.
The missile.
Come on, Sean.
The youngest man on the panel.
Yes. Okay. Now let's. We've only 2 minutes battery left, so.
Suits me.
Sean, I interviewed your granddad, John Loughlin, 20 years ago.
Yes.
21 years ago. Mm-hmm. You contributed to the goal today.
Yes.
Can you talk a bit about it?
All right, it's only 2 years out now. Would have done well to fuck it up now. And did my best and just picked it up and fired it into the back of the net.
But you were there.
I was there, yeah.
You were there.
Thanks to Shane Lohan now, I was there, he brought me on.
Thanks a million, Sean. Lovely job.
Bonish
1 minute. 30 seconds, Ronan.
This will be quick.
25.
General thoughts on the campaign overall, Ronan?
Look, in fairness, it was a good campaign, to be fair. I'd like to thank all the lads that togged out all year. Look, it was a long year, and it's nice to have. I'm playing a long time. I'm playing over 20 years, and we haven't won too many cups around here. Like so, anytime you get to a county final, it's nice to get to them. We got to the North Board, and we won today. So a lot of young lads blooded, and we just want to keep. It's about keeping the young lads in it. Like this, there was 32 lads named there. Like the club is strong. It's time to push on now, and let's get right behind the intermediate team now and push on for the year.
Stare of the earlier rounds
thanks,
when
everyone.
Players were few and far between.
How is the battery doing now?
And men were wanted to step up to the plate.
Yeah, you all did. I want to say is, now in fairness, an absolute unbelievable bunch of lads. Fucking Dolly, fair play to you. There wouldn't be a team here at all only for him.
Right.
Padraig Callaghan, the first game I went to, he got an absolutely horrendous injury. And he has stuck with us. Fucking brilliant stuff. And everyone else. But the young lads that were out there today. Besides Shamey, every other young lad out there is unbelievable.
Hi.
And they have unbelievable potential.
This is for all the poor horses that have never won a race. Those who lost in life for long, for those who lost their guide and nerve, their innocence and their driver, for those who feel they've been mistreated, discriminated, robbed or cheated, to claim one victory inspired, to injust ones is to just once against the
with us.
Some